Australian property markets continued to build momentum in December, with home values rising across all capital cities to finish 2020 at a level 3% higher than at the start of the year. Now, CoreLogic's latest look at housing markets showed the only capital city to record a negative change in dwelling values for 2020 was Melbourne, with the Victorian capital's median falling by 1.3%. So let's find out what's happening in your city with this month's market update. G'day guys, my name's Tim Guest and welcome to our market update video series where you can stay up to date with the markets matter, find out what's happening in your local area. Now please remember to like, comment and share this video, and if it's your first time tuning in, don't forget to follow or subscribe wherever you are seeing this. So despite a global pandemic, seven of Australia's eight capital cities all experienced price growth in 2020. Darwin was Australia's highest gainer with 9% capital growth, followed by Canberra on 7.5%, Hobart on 6.1%, and Adelaide on 5.9%. Brisbane's yearly growth was 3.6%, Sydney's was 2.7%, and Perth values rose by 1.9%. Now, regional markets performed more strongly with a 6.9% rate of capital growth outside areas included in the capital cities. Now, CoreLogic Research Director Tim Lawless said while there has been a mild dip in values due to the COVID crisis, the more telling factor was the unprecedented volatility in the number of transactions. Mr. Lawless said residential property sales plummeted by 40% through March and April, but finished the year with almost 8% more sales relative to a year ago. That's as buyer numbers surged through the second half of the year. Now, despite the volatility, housing values showed remarkable resilience, falling only 2.1% before rebounding with strength throughout the final quarter of 2020. Mr. Lawless said the resilience was largely down to the federal and state government's successful efforts to contain the pandemic and stimulate the economy through historically low interest rates. Now, the strength in regional markets was due to remote working opportunities becoming more prevalent and lower housing density options and lifestyle properties becoming more sought after. Now, Mr. Lawless said regional housing markets had generally underperformed relative to capital city regions. That's over the past decade, but 2020 saw regional housing values surge as demand outweighed supply. Price performance in 2020 was not as positive a story in unit and apartment markets, however, with unit values staying largely steady with a 0.2% yearly gain. Mr. Lawless said houses performed better than units in 2020 due to a range of factors. Unit markets have historically been more popular among investor buyers, he said, and demand from investors had been weighed down by weak rental conditions across the unit sector, along with high supply levels in some precincts. Transition of demand towards lower density housing options has helped to buoy those values. Now, rental conditions in 2020 diverged substantially from both a geographical perspective and across housing types. Now, annual rents grew strongly in Perth and Darwin, rising around 10% in both cities for houses and 6.8% for units in Perth, 7.6% for multi-residential in Darwin. That's on the back of strong demand and minimal new supply. Mr. Lawless said both Perth and Darwin have recorded below average levels of investor activity since housing market conditions started to cool in mid-2014, which has led to a shortage of rental stock. More recently, the stronger interstate migration driving housing demand, rental rates have been under substantial upwards pressure as demand for rentals outweighs supply. While in 2020 rents rose in Perth and Darwin, median rents remained just over 10% under their peak in May 2013 in Perth and around 20% below the 2014 peak in Darwin. In Melbourne and Sydney, unit markets experienced soft demand and high supply in 2020, leading to a sharp drop in median rents. Demand for units was impacted by stalled overseas migration and the exit of international students due to the pandemic, Mr. Lawless said. Melbourne unit rents fell by 7.6% in 2020, while Sydney units fell by 5.7%. Mr. Lawless said that while 2021 trajectory for Australian housing markets looked positive at present, there were still some substantial downside risks. He says as demonstrated by Melbourne's second round of lockdowns, new restrictions associated with a new outbreak that would set the economic recovery back, although these impacts would be temporary on housing markets. Closed international borders are another wild card. The longer borders remain closed, the greater the impacts on housing demand, especially rental demand. Now, regions where overseas migration has historically comprised of a larger portion of overall population growth, such as Melbourne and Sydney, will be impacted most by those prolonged border closures. Well, guys, that's it from me today. Now, please like, comment, and share this video, and don't forget to follow or subscribe wherever you are seeing this. Have a great week, and remember, there is only one thing in life that makes a difference, and that's action. Thanks a lot. Bye for now.